اب حضور علیہ السلام کے بعد بارش نہیں ہو رہی تھی، ایک حدیث پاک میں آتا ہے، یہ بخاری شریف ہے بیٹے، لکھیں حوالہ، اور اس کی کتاب ہے کتاب الاستسقاء، کتاب البارش مانگنے کا جو دعا ہوتی بارش، یہ بخاری شریف ہے، اور اس باب الاستسقاء میں حدیث نمبر، جو پرانی بخاری شریف کی حدیث نمبر آ رہا ہے نا سارا، وہ 1010 ہے، حدیث نمبر 1010 ہے. حضرت انس روایت کرتے ہیں کہ حضرت عمر فاروق رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ کا معمول تھا، کن کا؟ عمر فاروق رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ، ان عمر بن الخطاب رضی اللہ تعالیٰ عنہ کان اذا قحط استسقا بالعباس بن عبد المطلب، جب بارش نہ ہوتی، کیا نہ ہوتی اور قحط ہو جاتا، تو کان اذا قحط استسقا بالعباس بن عبد المطلب، تو پھر حضرت عمر فاروق اور صحابہ کرام حضور کے چچا حضرت عباس کو لے جاتے اور ان کے وسیلے سے بارش مانگتے. کیا؟ ان کے وسیلے سے، اور کہتے اللہ تعالی پہلے ہم آپ کے نبی کے وسیلے سے مانگتے تھے اور تو ہمیں بارش دیتا تھا، اب ہم حضور کے چچا کا وسیلہ تجھے دے رہے ہیں بارش عطا کر. فقال فیسقون، پھر ان کو بارش عطا ہوتی. تو گویا دوسروں کے وسیلے سے حضور کے چچا، تو ان کو بھی نسبت کس کی تھی؟ کسی اور کو کیوں نہیں پکڑ لیا؟ حضور کی چچا ہے، تو اس نسبت سے یہ بخاری شریف میں حدیث آ گئی. تو گویا اس طرح بھی یہ کون کرتے تھے؟ صحابہ کرام. اور حضرت کس کا نام ہے؟ حضرت عمر فاروق رضی اللہ عنہ.
They brought this idea of asking Allah through the Prophet ﷺ or other righteous people that they claim through many narrations. All of them are da'if. Now, even though they debate the authenticity of these narrations and they claim that they are sahih, they are not sahih, they are not sahih, they are not sahih. And if you were a scholar of hadith, or if you were to refer to the scholars of hadith and their discussion on the chain of narrators, it will become clear to you that these narrations are inauthentic. Inauthentic meaning not authentic. Except two. Except two. And these two, the amazing thing is that these two narrations, which we agree with them are sahih, are actually evidences against them and not evidences for them. They are evidences against them and not evidences for them. So what are these narrations? Let me quote the narrations for you. The first hadith عن أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه أن عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه كان إذا قحطوا أو قحطوا استسقى بالعباس بن عبد المطلب. أنس بن مالك said, whenever it used to be, whenever there was drought, whenever there was drought, Umar radiallahu anhu used to seek rain, istisqa, seek rain through Al-Abbas, the uncle of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You follow me? Anytime there was drought, there was no rain, they will ask Allah, they will beg Allah, they will do istisqa through the uncle Al-Abbas bin Abdul Muttalib, the uncle of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فقال اللهم إنا كنا نتوسل إليك بنبينا فتسقينا وإنا نتوسل إليك بعم نبينا فاسقنا قال فيسقون وفي هذا في بخاري وفي رواية قم يا عباس فادعوا الله وفي رواية في المصنف لعبد الرزاق قم فاستسقي. طيب so what did they say? Anytime there was drought, عمر رضي الله عنه will bring Al-Abbas, the uncle of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now listen, and he used to say, فقال, اللهم, O Allah, we used to, now this is where technicality comes in, we used to draw near to you, seek nearness to you, through the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There's something missing here, but I will explain later, don't stop listening. We used to seek nearness to you through the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and now we are seeking nearness to you through the uncle of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. You get it? And you used to give us rain when we saw through the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, so give us rain now. So give us rain Now, then Anas said, فَيُسْقَوْنَ. And so they used to be given rain. Whenever they would do this, Allah will give them rain. In one of the narrations, Umar used to say, يَا عَبَّاسِ O Abbas, قُمْ. Get up, فَدْعُ اللَّهِ. And ask, beg Allah. Invoke Allah. In another narration, قُمْ فَاسْتَسْقِي. Get up and seek rain from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But now the Sufis, they say, and the grave worshippers, and those who are inclined towards this issue, with the minority of the people of the Sunnah who misunderstood this topic and had an off position, they say, look, they were asking Allah. The hadith says, we used to natawassalu ilayk binabiyina. We used to seek nearness to you through our prophet. And you would give us rain. Now we are seeking, you know, نتوسل إليك بعمي نبينا. So then they must be asking Allah through the honor, the virtue, the status of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You see the justification? This is how they justify it. That this is what it means. طيب. The Sufis claim that this is, you know, how one should make seek rain, or how should one ask Allah for things through the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So they go to his grave and they do that. Question, was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam dead or alive during this hadith? He was dead. Some people don't like to hear the word dead, right? If you have been brought up in an environment where they tell you that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is alive, when you hear dead, like, oh, you know, don't offend us. Akhi, Allah told him in the Quran, innaka mayyitun wa innahum mayyitun. You will die. He's dead, alayhi salatu wasalam. He's dead, alayhi salatu wasalam. And that doesn't degrade his status in our sight, nor does that defame him, alayhi salatu wasalam. He remains the messenger of Allah, the one who we love and cherish and follow in the best way we can. But he's dead, alayhi salatu wasalam. He had passed away. If seeking rain or anything else through the dead was allowed, why did not Umar go to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam in his grave and say, oh, messenger of Allah, give us rain. Ask Allah to give us rain. Why would they go to the Abbas? That's the first refutation. That's the first refutation. They claim that it's permissible to seek through the dead. Here's the Sahaba. Now, could at any time in this life, could Al-Abbas ever be better than the Messenger of Allah? Could he ever be better than him? So then would they leave the Prophet ﷺ and go to the Abbas, even though the Prophet is better? No. They wouldn't have done so unless they had known that it is not permissible to go to the grave of a dead man and ask him anything. You see how beautiful that is? That's the first refutation which we have for them. Secondly, the status of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam does not end with his death. His jah with Allah, his honor with Allah is eternal. In Jannah, he will remain the most honorable of all. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whether he's dead or alive, it does not affect his status with Allah. So then why would they go to Al-Abbas if the jah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is superior to that of Al-Abbas? If they, because they knew that this was not permissible. The third point, Al-Abbas actually said, Al-Abbas himself said in the dua, which was narrated in the other narrations, اللهم إنه لا ينزل بلاء إلا بذنب ولا يكشف إلا بتوبة, until the end of the hadith. Oh Allah, no calamity befalls us except because of our sin, and it is never removed unless we repent from the sin. So then he begged Allah and he said, we turn to you in repentance and they will grant it rain. If they were only asking through the jah of the Prophet ﷺ, what is the point of Al-Abbas making dua? If they said, oh Allah, we ask you through the Messenger of Allah. Or let's say they were doing tawassul through Al-Abbas. If Umar said, oh Allah, we are asking you through Al-Abbas, then why would the Abbas make dua? It would be futile. It'll be of no point. There'll be no point in making dua when the tawassul had already been done. But they understood that tawassul did not mean what the innovators define it as today. They understood that tawassul was actually seeking nearness to Allah through the dua of the righteous man. So look at the understanding of the Sahaba. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is dead in the grave, we don't go do tawassul through him. Al-Abbas is alive, his uncle, who was a righteous man, still through the living, we don't do tawassul to him except by asking him to make dua. قُمْ فَدْعُ. Umar told him, get up and make dua. He made dua, Allah blessed them with rain. is the concept of tawassul was valid according to the grave worshippers and the Sufis, there would be no need for the person to make dua. It would have been automatically granted as soon as they asked for the jah of this person whom they claim Allah Azza wa Jal will give him because of him. Now, so what does that explain? That explains that there's something omitted in the text. Something omitted in the text which we must understand in the light of other narrations and in the light of the Quran and the Sunnah. It's one of two options. Either they used to say, Allahumma inna kunna natawassalu ilayk bijahi nabiyyik. We used to seek nearness to you through the status of your Prophet so you would give us rain, and now we are seeking tawassul, we are seeking nearness to you through the jah, the status of Al-Abbas, so give us rain. Or the other possibility in the hidden, the omitted words is, O Allah, we used to seek nearness to you through the dua of the Prophet ﷺ, and now we are seeking nearness to you through the dua of his uncle Al-Abbas. It's one of these two possibilities, there's no third. And this is where we differ with the people of innovation. We say that the hidden, the omitted words are dua and not the status of the person. Why? Let me reinforce this in a number of ways. First of all, the hadith says, kana. Look at the hadith. Kana idha qahatu. In the Arabic language, kana means when. One of the meanings is when. For example, I say, when Ramadan comes, we fast. What does that mean? That every time, whenever Ramadan comes, we fast. It is not a single incident. It's something that is repeated on and on. Every time Ramadan comes, we fast. When Ramadan comes, we fast. Clear? The hadith says, kana. They're used to. Whenever they would have drought, they would ask. Whenever they had drought, they would ask Al-Abbas radiallahu anhu wa ardah to make dua. This explains the idea. Hold on. Would gather and beg Allah through the status of the Prophet ﷺ, or would they go to him and ask him for dua? Now, how did they do it at the time of the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ? You remember the hadith in Jumu'ah? When they wanted rain, what did they do? They went to the Prophet ﷺ and said what? Make dua for Allah Azza wa Jal to give us rain. That means, when during his life we used to do tawassul ilayk. Now we're trying to prove that what is the missing word is dua. How did they make tawassul to Allah? Through the dua of the Prophet ﷺ. And now we are doing it through the Abbas. So how is it going to be done? Through the dua of Al-Abbas. Because during his life, the Prophet ﷺ, they did it through his what? His dua. Subhanallah al-Azim. Beautiful explanation of the ulama, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah and others. Of course, they don't like Ibn Taymiyyah at all. Furthermore, other narrations explain and prove